just about over, but this frost tonight might take care of any, what, remaining tomato plants we have left.
That's right. Tomatoes are very sensitive to the cold, and if you want to keep them going for a while, you might want to take some precautions tonight because it's going to cool down. You remember today we had very windy conditions and clear skies, and what's happened tonight is the wind has calmed down, and the skies are clear, so that allows all the heat just to escape into the atmosphere, so it's going to get quite cool, down to about 32, so scattered frost is a possibility. Today on the Weather Almanac, we did get up to a high of 57 degrees and a low of 42. Now, compared to the normal, that's right on target for the high, and the low, however, normal low is 36, and that's not quite where we should be. We're a little warmer. Nowhere near the record of 73 in 1963, however, but the 22, we're starting to see that as the months go on. Now, we can see on the tonight's map, there's a big, large, high-pressure area right over the center part of the country. It affects the whole western two-thirds. The bad weather that we had has been pushed out by this high, and we see it now out here in the east coast where it's spreading its bad weather from the middle Atlantic states down to Louisiana. That frontal system is what gave us that horrible weather for the last 6 days with the clouds and the drizzle, and we can see the symbol there, little commas. That means it's drizzling still out in the middle Atlantic states, and me and Mr. Chuck Buckler know that's due to stratospheric turbulent discontinuities. No more of that, though. The satellite picture shows us this band of clouds. Now, there's not a whole lot of rain. This band of clouds runs down from Ohio, down here behind me, into Texas. Not a whole lot of rain, but a lot of drizzle up there in Pennsylvania. But look over here, and we can see that high pressure has moved in over here and given a massive area of clear skies to the western two-thirds of the country, and it's going to stay that way for a while. The lows, now since this high has a clockwise circulation, it's bringing down cooler temperatures. You see temperatures just to our north are going to be below freezing and even in the 20s in the extreme northern part of Minnesota. A large area of 30s across the whole United States. The only place it's going to be warm is 60s in California and some 50s down here in the southern part of Texas. Tomorrow's map, what's going to happen is that high is just going to move a little bit more to the east. It's going to be centered just about in the same place, but its effects are going to come a little bit farther down to the south and clear out the showers you saw on the current map. The only place it'll still be raining is up here in the middle Atlantic states where things will still be retreating rather slowly. They'll see rain showers, rain and drizzle, the same weather we saw for the last 6 days. This little disturbance right up here into our north won't have any weather associated. It'll just move on by without us even knowing it. A little bit of clouds moving in the Pacific Northwest. The high temperatures, a massive recovery in temperature for this time of year, 70s, all the way up into the southern part of Canada. It's very good and very hard to achieve this time of year, so they should enjoy it while they can. But you can see colder temperatures will be out here to the northeast of us, 50s and even 40s in the New England states under that miserable cloud cover, 80s down in California will be the rule, and a little bit of cool weather coming into the Pacific Northwest. Now, looking ahead to the current conditions, we have a temperature of 43 degrees right now in DeKalb, and that's going to drop about 10 more degrees tonight before we're all done. A relative humidity of 65%. The pressure is 29.22, and it's high because of that high pressure is moving in. Tonight, clear and much cooler, low of about 32, some areas a little colder, chance of frost. Tomorrow, sunny and warmer, a high of 61 degrees, and the temperature will be recovering over the next couple of days under clear skies. Those same clear skies will keep it cold tomorrow night with a low of 32 once again, another chance of frost tomorrow night. Moving on to Thursday, sunny and still warmer still with a high of 65, Chris, and those temperatures should keep climbing all the way through the weekend, warmer and warmer, and continued clear skies. So cross your fingers, it might last for a while.
Are you going to go bathing during the weekend?
Well, some of the wilder people might, but I think I'll just enjoy the warmer temperature.
70s weekend.
It's a possibility. It is. It's possible we might get 70 by Saturday.
Are we going to see any snow?
Not in the foreseeable future, but hang on. The weather around here changes very quickly.
Just so we have no more stratospheric discontinuity.